The name of this video is Energy Caveats. So now that we know a little bit about the Dirac Delta, it's worth looking at an interesting case, that of the electrostatic energy of a single point like a charged particle in space with charge small q. Okay, so suppose that at the beginning of time, our particle q is located behind our infinite boundary, which means it does not interact with the lab where we are living down here. There is nothing else in the lab, there is only vacuum, which means in this case, if I bring along any path this particle to a point capital Q within this region of space, what is the work we need to perform against the field forces? So what is the external work, which is also called the electrostatic energy, required to perform this movement? Well, in this case, there is no other particle generating the field. The work of the external forces, which is equal to UE, is exactly equal to zero, as we have seen already in a previous video. Now, suppose that by mistake, as it turns out, we want to use this expression for the electrostatic energy. UE equal 1/2 epsilon naught, the volume integral in the entire universe, capital omega infinite, of E quantity square, the norm of the electrostatic field square, in dr cube. We know that E, for a charge Q, a point capital Q, is of Coulombian type. So this can be readily rewritten as 1/2 epsilon naught. As omega infinite, as always, we can choose an infinite sphere. And so this integral becomes, as always, the integral from 0 to 2 pi, d bar phi, integral from 0 to pi, d theta, sine theta. We are expressing a volume element in 3D in spherical coordinate systems. This is part of that. And finally, we want to have the integral between 0 and a certain small r, which eventually we will push to plus infinite because we want to build an infinite universe. This is in dr, okay, because we are also pushing in the third dimension. This must be multiplied times r squared. Okay, so now we took care of dr cube and 1/2 epsilon naught. What about e square? Not to forget that. It's 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught from Coulomb's law, but square. What about, so this times, let's go down here. This times, what about the rest of the electrostatic field? Well, obviously, it has to be this point-like charge q divided by, which has to be square, because again, it's e square, divided by r square, square, which is r to the power of 4. Great, so that we can take care of this. This becomes power of 2, okay? So these are all constants, 1/2 epsilon naught, this gives me a 2 pi, this gives me a 2. So these are all, q squared is a constant, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught squared is a constant, which means this integral, now what we want to do, we want to go and calculate this integral in the limit for small r, which pushes to plus infinite to obtain omega infinite, capital omega infinite, and this limit of something proportional to, where this proportionality is because all these are all constants. So again, 1/2 epsilon naught 2 pi 2, and 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught square and q square are all constants. So the only integration is 1 over r square, which gives us minus 1 over r integrated between 0 and r, which now we are pushing to infinite. Okay, so 1 over infinite, of course, minus 1 over infinite is 0. So that's all good. Minus minus is plus 1 over 0. 1 over 0 is infinite. We get plus infinite. Plus infinite is quite different than this result up here. So here we obtain a plus infinite, and here we obtain a 0. Okay, so the energy should be 0, and we obtain a plus infinite. There is an infinite distance between these two values. Note that in the case of the shell, which we have seen in another video, which will be the same for a hard sphere as well, this quantity here actually was a capital R, different than 0. Okay, but that was for a hard sphere or for a shell. Okay, so in this case, of course, we have it equal to zero. All right. Obviously, this approach clearly gives the wrong result. Why is it so? Because as I said, the only scenario when you can use this expression for the electrostatic energy is when rho is well defined. This is a C naught, it's a continuous function in the entire space omega infinite, and is also limited in that space. Now, in this case, what is our rho? Now we know the Dirac delta, so we know that the rho associated with a point-like charge in space can be rewritten, rho of r, as the charge itself, q, times the Dirac delta at r, suppose that we send it in the origin. Clearly, this is not a function, it's a distribution, so obviously, this assumption here is not fulfilled, so you cannot use this expression here. You cannot, that's why it gives the wrong result. Instead, what we should have done is to use the usual, a general equation, which is the one we started from in order to derive this after imposing that condition. And so the way to proceed is to write UE as 1/2 with the total generic expression, volume integral on a region omega, which at the very least has to contain the particle, it could be the particle itself in this case, of rho times the electrostatic potential times the element dRQ cube. Okay, note again that, let's make a note on this omega could be either just the point where the particle is located, so just Q, or if you want, it can be the entire omega infinite, it doesn't matter, because we know that the Dirac delta, which is eventually what we need to use here, is zero for any other point except for where the charge is located. So, let's use the infinite one, because it's a little bit more formal, but it gives the same result, obviously. So here, we just write this as 1/2. The volume integral, again, so we need to go from 0 to 2 pi in dV phi, the usual things. The integral from 0 to pi d theta sine theta. Integral from 0 to r, which eventually we push to plus infinite to obtain omega infinite. Dr, r square, as always. Now we need rho. What is rho? Rho is q, delta of r. Let's write it like this. And what about r in a spherical coordinate system? This becomes just a single r here, without vector, because we are already in a spherical coordinate system. So this is our rho. What about v? V is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, Coulombian type, q divided by r. So we took care of the drq cube. Yeah, it's all in here, here, and here. 1/2 is there, and the potential is there, and the density is also there. Okay. So this integral becomes a bunch of constants. 2 times 2 pi, 2 divided by 2 is 1, so it becomes 2 pi from here. 2 pi divided by 4 pi is 1 over 2, so we get q over 2 epsilon naught, q squared over 2 epsilon naught. Q squared over 2 epsilon naught. So q we took care of, r we still need to integrate it, but there is this r squared here, epsilon naught we took care of, there is this delta, and all the rest we took care of. All right, so now let's go straight to this limit. Let me not formally write the limit here. What we get in here is going to be r cancels with this r squared here. So we end up having the integral from 0 to plus infinite, which definitely contains the region where the particle is located, which is actually zero, of dr, a function r, which is just this left over, times delta of r. Now, in class I told you that I want you to discuss about an important property of the Dirac delta, which I'm here summarizing. The property was, what happens when we perform the integral on omega infinite, which is what we are doing here, in dr vector cube of a function f of r, delta Dirac, r minus r naught. Well, this integral, as it turns out, is super simple. I will not prove it, but you could if you were to work on, to study theory distributions. So this In this case, whenever you have the integral in over the entire space of a function, a scalar function, in this case, the function is just r. This is our f of r, in our case, in our spherical coordinate system. It's a simple function, just r, okay? And you multiply times the Dirac delta, in our case, is centered in zero, so it's at zero. Well, the result of this integral is nothing but the function evaluated at r equal where the Dirac delta is translated to, which is r naught. And if r naught happens to be equal to zero, well, then this means that the result is f at zero in the origin, okay? That's a fundamental property, which I will not prove, but we use it here, okay, down here. When we use it, obviously, we get a function times the delta Dirac centered in the origin. Besides these constants, which are just constants, this means is r evaluated at zero times a bunch of constants, okay, which are these constants here. R at zero is zero. Zero times constant is zero. So in this case, interestingly enough, as expected, we get an energy which is zero, exactly as the one which we expected from a qualitative discussion of this problem. So the caveat, the warning is, when you have non-continuous or strange charge distributions, do not attempt to use this equation for E squared. The only case where I know where it's okay is, for example, the case of a shell, then you can use it, because if you confine yourself in the subspace of the shell itself, in that shell, sigma is continuous, so you can still use it. But in general, you can only use it when you're considering rods, which are continuous and limited in space. In the case of a point-like charge, clearly it's not continuous and limited. It's the biggest discontinuity you can get is nothing, nothing, nothing in all space in 3D. And at some point, there is a charge which spikes there where it's concentrated. That's why it's representing the distribution, which is the Dirac delta. So obviously, you cannot use this expression. It gives you an energy which is infinitely far from the actual result, which is zero. Instead, you can always use the generic expression, integral of rho v, which, using the Dirac delta notation, gave us zero as a result. That's it.